23, 8, 17. Those aren't just random numbers. It's the date for today's review of Boruto episode 21, Sasuke and Sarada. It's time to deal with some daddy issues. Holy shit, I need to work on my one sentence introductions. That was fucking terrible. And man, are you ready to get hyped? Because this episode was pretty darn hype. This definitely was the nearest thing to feeling like a episode of Shippuden. Or, well, one of the later episodes of Shippuden when the action, you know, started and stuff. But the first half was, you know, a nice look at Sarada kind of trying to get through to Sasuke. But Sasuke being a bit of a cold dick. Which, you know, is kind of what Sasuke has been doing since he was born. Well, okay, I guess since Itachi killed all of his family. Before then, he seemed pretty cool and friendly. Also, shout out to Chocho for defusing the situation there and being the best girl of this series, hands down. I think everyone can agree. Is Sasuke Chocho's dad? Who knows? And man, the second half of this episode really took a turn from kind of a semi-slow-paced kind of serious thing about Sarada reconnecting with Sasuke to all of a sudden, yo, I'm going to reform the Akatsuki, which, don't get me wrong, I am pretty darn excited for. Of all of the kind of villain plans that have presented themselves in the entirety of Naruto and Naruto Shippuden, this probably is one of the times that I'm really hoping the bad guy kind of gets away with this in some regard, because I really liked the Akatsuki in Shippuden. I think I just got something for like a team of guys, like a variety of people, not necessarily just a team of guys, a team of aliens, robots, whatever. And I'm really liking that Shin Uchiha, which is the father of Shin Uchiha and all of his clones, Shin Uchiha, took the time to kind of stitch together an Akatsuki cloak for himself. Well, he found one, I guess. I don't know. I'm sure they're probably not going to explain that. He probably made it himself, though, I imagine. And man, what is up with his eye? That is a really weird looking thing. It's like all peeled back skin and stuff. And there's the weird black kind of things that look like they were what Pain had impaled in him. Well, okay, maybe not impaled, inserted in him. You know what I mean. And I'm just going to say it. I think this is the first time I've ever been really hyped to see Sakura appear. Like, that fight scene overall was pretty darn cool. I thought that, you know, the whole manipulation of Sasuke's sword to stab Naruto and stuff was a cool little dramatic twist. And then, you know, Sasuke getting stabbed and stuff. And I was like, oh man, it looks like Sarada's going to have to hold her own against these two. But then Sakura came in and I don't know, I was actually really getting into it. I was like, damn, this is a good fight. Wasn't a particularly long fight or really all that dramatic, but I don't know, it kind of got me in the right places. And overall, that's kind of what I look for in anime fights a lot of the time, unless I'm expecting them to be really meaningful or whatever. I don't really care as long as it's an engaging fight, and this one was, like, props to them. And oof, what a way to end this episode. See, I thought from the preview of the last episode, which going back and looking at it now, I thought the black hooded figure was Sasuke that had appeared in their dimension. But it just turned out it was older Shin. Dad Shin? What are people calling him? I'm going to call him Father Shin, because I think that makes the most sense. I don't know really what's going on. Has he cloned himself? Are the younger Shins technically him, but, you know, obviously younger, so they call him Father? I don't know. But, yeah. So yeah, I messed up last week's next time segment by saying that Sasuke went to their dimension where he didn't. Although Sakura did, because she was sucked in. Now, I gotta admit, whatever the hell weapon Shin is using is actually kind of cool. I don't know how practical it is really, but it looks really cool. I like the design, like it's got a little thing to hold in the middle, but still a large bulky blade and stuff. Reminds me a little bit of the Elite's sword from Halo. And overall, this is just a straight-up enjoyable episode. It, like, started out a little bit slow, but, you know, dramatic. And then it ramped up and stuff. And it presented the potential for an Akatsuki in the future, or some kind of group. I mean, I don't know if that will actually happen. They'll probably be shut down before we can set one up. But, you know, it was a nice little callback. And man, talking about callbacks, it is time for next time. And oh yeah, Orochimaru is back. Well, he didn't really go anywhere, I guess. But it'll be cool to see him. And also Sugetsu seems to be there as well, which is cool. I am hoping to see more of... Is it Heavy? Was that their name? Sasuke's group? Because I remember they were Taka and then they weren't. And I think then they were Heavy. Whatever. Either way, we get to see some Orochimaru and maybe Sugetsu. And possibly Karin and Jugo. I'm kind of hoping they all team up and stuff and go after the Shins together as a kind of old throwback group and stuff. Also, something I forgot to mention, but I mentioned this last episode, and that, like, I was impressed that Boruto only showed up for, like, a minute or two of last episode. He has not appeared at all in this episode whatsoever. He didn't make any appearance, apart from, obviously, the opening video, but, you know, that's just the opening animation to the show, so that doesn't really count. And it looks like next week probably isn't going to have Boruto in either. I'm really liking that this series is literally kind of like a world-building kind of thing, or a continuation of the overall story, not just the story of one ninja. And that about wraps it up for this review of episode 21 of Boruto. I hope you all enjoyed. If you did enjoy, do feel free to leave a like or a dislike if you didn't like how it turned out. And of course, if you do want to subscribe, that would be very much appreciated. I am one day hoping to reach 100 subscribers. I'm more than halfway there, so, you know, it's a realistic goal. Give it a couple years, I may make it there, I don't know. And of course, if you have anything you'd like to contribute, do feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below. And until next time, goodbye!